guys. Thanks for stopping by my channel. Today I'm going to do a process video for you. It's been a while since I've done a process video, so be gentle with your comments. I'm still trying to figure out my camera location and everything. So anyways, I'm going to do a single page layout here, and it's just two of the same, almost exact photos, except for the expressions on my kids' faces are different. We went to the Teenage Ninja movie a while back, and I had found this paper here that I'm cutting out with the turtles on it. It is from Paper Studio from Hobby Lobby, and I thought this would be perfect for this layout. So I just went ahead and cut that giant turtle out of the hexagon paper. And yes, I had to remove my Heidi Swap mat there, so I just cannot work on that unless I'm doing some spray misting. It's too slippery for me. I'm also going to use my hexagon punch to go ahead and punch out various hexagon shapes here with the turtles inside. I could cut these easily, but I might as well use my punch since I have it. And I'm going to struggle a little bit with this. I'm having to trim paper and to get the punch to fit in exactly around the hexagon shapes of the turtle. And so you'll see me at times try to find the correct colors that I'm looking for. I kind of wanted a variety of colors between the red, blue, and orange and purple to put on my layout. So this was a really fun layout to do. It's very themey, so that seems to be mainly how I scrapbook, whether it's with theme products or just theme in general, like travel or Christmas. So I'm going to also use this kind of herringbone green and blue paper, also from the Paper Studio, and I'm gutting the center out. I use my Fiskars trimmer, and I put it at 2, and I slice down to 10, and then just keep rotating my paper till I have the center cut out. And then I decided to trim off a little bit of my background white cardstock, just so I could use that on top of that pattern paper. And I really like how that looks. So I'm going to go ahead and ink the edges of the white cardstock just to have it stand out a bit against that herringbone paper. It's a pretty busy paper, and I just wanted to add a little bit more blue. The inside that I gutted out of that 12 by 12, I will be using later to mat my photos. That's a great way to, if you only have like one piece of the paper, pattern paper, it's a great way to use the center to be able to mat your photos so they match. And yes, of course, my ATG had to run out while I was doing this video. I'm going to struggle as well with this ATG gun. I buy the generic ATG tape. And once in a while, I'll get one of the refills that just doesn't want to work correctly when you peel back the starter tape. And so sometimes I get just frustrated with that, and that happened to happen. So I'm going to have to open another tape, and I will eventually fix that tape, but I wanted just to continue creating this layout. So bear with me as I continue to get my tape gun going here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and finish getting adhesive on that and go ahead and adhere that. I'm messing with my mat, excuse my mat. It's really dirty. I had some hot glue on there that was kind of bumpy, and I wanted to get that off so it wasn't lumpy on my layout. Now I'm just going ahead and placing the hexagons with the turtles on them in a pattern, kind of diagonal pattern across my page, going towards the larger turtle that you see in the bottom left. And I'm cutting also with my hexagon punch some colored cardstock, and I'll be cutting orange, blue, and purple. And I'll just play around a little bit with the location of how I want the layout to look with the different hexagons. I had a lot of fun creating this layout. It didn't take me very long, and it was fun to just break out a punch and just to be creative with it. And honestly, I only used two pattern papers, and then a couple scraps of cardstock. So I'm going to continue to just go ahead and trim down a few of the smaller turtle hexagons. The paper had two different sizes on it, so you'll notice that there are some smaller images of the turtles, and then there are some kind of larger ones. And I went ahead and just kind of played around. Now I'm trying to figure out how I want this. I know I want them kind of going off the page, and then I'll trim those in a bit. Here I go, trying to mat those. I'm gonna have to trim down my photos because they're a little bit too big for that piece of paper that I gutted out of the center, but no big deal. So I'm gonna go ahead and put those down, and I'm gonna end up taking that photo that I just laid down off because it just was a little bit too big and I felt that I needed to trim off the other one first so I didn't make a mistake. And I'm gonna put it down and I'm gonna tear it off again because I feel like it's still not quite the right size. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just trim a little bit off and then I'll finally get it adhered down to the pattern paper. And now I'm gonna go ahead and just use my ATG and I'm just running a really small little strip across the back of those hexagons and placing them down. My kids are not into teenage Ninja Turtles, but this was a really fun movie to go to. It was, you know, a nice family movie, something that we could all enjoy going to. And so they had that kind of set up in the movie theater with the promo for the movie, a very 3D kind of little promo there. So the kids went ahead and stood by it, and I went ahead and took a couple pictures of them. I thought it would be a fun a layout to do. And then I happened to come upon these papers at Hobby Lobby, and so I picked them up. So I'm just putting my photos down and calling that a day. And then I'm going to continue to work on the other side here and just go ahead and adhere the big turtle and the rest of the hexagons down. And then I'll move on to my title. So I noticed that I needed a little bit more cardstock as well. I kind of like working in odd numbers, and so you'll notice that I have, I don't have odd numbers of the colored cardstock on there, like three purple, three blue, three orange, but I will fix that here in a second, and I will go ahead and add a couple more of those hexagons that I cut out with my punch with the cardstock, just to balance the color and for the movement of your eye so it looks more consistent. And I love that I was able to use the paper as my embellishments. That's a fun thing to do if you don't have any accessories or ephemera or anything that goes with pattern paper, to sometimes buy two pieces of it and you can use the paper and just fussy cut out the images. It's a great way to use up the pattern paper and to get embellishments at the same time for your layout. So I'm going to go ahead and just add, like you saw, I added in a few more pieces of cardstock and then just a few more hexagons of the turtles. And now I know that I need to go ahead and adhere my title down. That was epic. And those are some old Heidi Swap titles that I absolutely love. I wish that I could find those because I'm running really low on them and they're so fun and I love the handwriting and the mix of the font. Here I'm going through some wood veneers. I'm going to just add a few in with different sayings on them so that I can just embellish it a little bit more. And I think that looks really nice. And I'm just going to play around a little bit with a few more the wood veneers. I really wanted to put another one of those kind of arrows, the thicker arrows, but I only had the two, so I just went with the two. And then I just put a larger regular arrow over by the word epic. I also pulled out some of these They're kind of like enamel stars in silver and gold. I'm going to put those on eventually, but I'm going to ink the edges with the same blue ink that I edged the white cardstock with, just to have the wood veneer stand out a little bit. And I really like how this turned out. Just gave it that little extra dimension that I was needing so they could pop off of the page. And I'm going to also go ahead and just do the arrow. And now I'm going to take off the clear backing. I'm cutting that apart just to make it was two words, so it'd be easier to place it down so I can get my placement correct. So I'm just going to go ahead and use my tweezers and place the title down. I really love using those tweezers for small details like that. It helps line it up. Your fingers aren't getting in the way. So the wood veneers that I put down in the on the cardstock says yeah, crazy, cool, and good times. And I thought those were appropriate for this layout with the turtles and all their attitude. I thought those went perfect. I really love Heidi Swap's handwriting, especially on the word epic. It's so cool. I really hope that she comes back out with some more titles like this because I love them. I'm sure if I searched online, I could probably find them again, but I'm just trying to use up my stash. And then I'm going to use some glue dots to go ahead and adhere down all the wood veneers. I find that this is the fastest and easiest way for me versus liquid glue. I'll just go ahead and grab the glue dots, and that seems to hold pretty well for me. I was trying not to get ink on my fingers because I knew if I touched my white cardstock in the background there that I could possibly leave a blue smudge. And so I was trying pretty hard not to use my fingers, but I gave up on my tweezers and just went for it with my fingers and adding the glue dots. I think those round wood veneers that have the sayings on them were Studio Calico. I've had them for a long time. I'm really bad about not using wood veneers, and so I'm going to try harder to break those out and start using them. Here I took out those epoxy sparkly stars, and I'm just kind of figuring out where I want to place them. I'm kind of going to do like a cluster of three of them around the layout, and I think I'm going to do them in the clusters with the wood veneers there. And I really like how that turned out as well. And I'm going to grab some enamel dots to finish off the layout. And I think I am using purple and the dark blue color. And I'm going to once again put them in the little clusters that I've created with the wood veneer and the star. And I'm just going to mess around a little bit to find the perfect shade of blue there. And I found it. And I'm going to go ahead and put that down. I think I end up moving the star because it was up a little too high for me. I'll go back and I'll move that. And then I dropped my enamel dot on my photo, and I was so thankful it didn't really stick that well, so I could get it off in time before it wrecked my photo. And I think I'm almost done with this layout. I'm going to go ahead and journal just a tiny bit. There's really no story to this. It basically says family night out at the movies and then the date. I think the pictures explain themselves, that it was the Teenage Mutant Ninja movie. Everybody's holding their popcorn and their soda, and so yeah, that was it. Thanks guys for stopping by, and I will see you in the next video. Stay tuned for still shot photos. Thanks guys.